The situation in Malaya became chaotic as a result of the criminal activities and intransigence of the MPAJA, which evolved into the Malayan Communist Party. Racial disharmony and mutual suspicion were an increasing cause for alarm. The MPAJA sought revenge on the Malays whom they suspected of having collaborated with the Japanese. Batu Pahat and Muar in Johor, as well as Sungai Manik in Perak, were scenes of bloodshed. In October 1945, after the British Military Administration, BMA, took over the administration of the country, the British announced the Malayan Union proposals. These proposals of Sir Harold McMichael were aimed at coordinating economic development and opportunities for investment among the different states. The British government sent Sir Harold McMichael to Malaya on a mission to obtain the Malay rulers' consent for the proposals. The rulers consented on pain of dethronement for wartime collaboration with the enemies. The Malayan Union Constitution was finally approved by the British Parliament on 22nd January 1946. The Malay states were to be placed directly under the British Crown. The Malayan Union was officially proclaimed on April 1, 1946. The plan was as follows: to unite the nine Malay states and the two straits settlements of Penang and Malacca, Singapore was to be out of the Union. To appoint a governor as head of state, assisted by Legislative Council and Executive Council. The Legislative Council was to be responsible for making laws. It was to include the governor as well as both official and unofficial members. The executive councils were to be responsible for government administration. State executive councils, presided by resident commissioners, were to be formed in all the states. The Sultan was to preside over the advisory council, whose members were to be appointed by the British. The council had jurisdiction over matters solely relating to the Islamic religion as well as Malay customs and traditions. Citizenship status was to be granted to non-Malays who fulfill the following conditions: be born in Malaya in the period following the formation of the Malayan Union, must be 18 years of age and above and have resided in Malaya for 10 out of 15 years before 15 February 1942. The proposals clearly disappointed the Malays. It became a catalyst for the raising of awareness amongst the Malays, who were united with one voice in resisting British colonialism. The opposition was imperative for the purpose of ensuring the continued survival and dominance of the Malays in their own land.